ain't no new thing.
Now, Yusuf Lateef told me personally that he don't play jazz. He don't even want to hear the word. He called it audio, psycho, and physio music.
It's just something which is very personal, you know what I mean? It's something which, you know, to me there's nothing better than going home and listening to a bit of McCoy Tyner. It's difficult to explain what it is, but, you know, I feel it and I believe it, and that's what it's all about, really. You know.
Jazz for me is an attitude. You know, it's a music which is kind of born out of difficulties and oppression, but it's one which is kind of, it's about creativity. It's about stretching the boundaries. You know, I mean, it must have been amazing to have heard Charlie Parker when he was really flying. It must have been amazing to hear John Coltrane when he was kicking against the boundaries, you know.
Well, John Coltrane was one of my favorite artists, man, you know. And I used to be a saxophone player myself. As a matter of fact, one of my favorite things, I play soprano saxophone on the introduction. And, you know, I love playing the saxophone, and that was one of my favorite tunes by John, so I did my own version of that tune, though, you know.
Hey, you know, like in Pieces of a Man, we said this is energy that comes from the spirits. It's supposed to be used and passed on, so like we see Oscar Brown Jr. and Leroy Jones and the Last Poets as people that gave us some energy that we use and passing on, and it's very pleasing to see that other folks are getting into the same idea, that this is not a field of ideas are not out of date.
I was one of the guys, man, that dug the Last Poets, man, way back in the 60s, man, you know. And they were the first rappers, I think, to come along, you know. Even though they came along with the message, they were still rapping, you know. And they rapped off of jazz, and they rapped off of rhythms and beats and things like that. And that's what's happening today, you know. And it's great that they can take old jazz standards and old jazz tracks, man, and add to those tracks, and they bring those musicians back alive again, you know.
What we tried to do was be saying what they were playing, and I think we succeeded to a large extent. We tried to interpret what Coltrane was playing. We tried to interpret what Shep was doing, what Alice Coltrane was doing, what McCoy Tyner was doing, all of these people.
You hear some Coltrane in rap artists, and you hear some of me in rap artists, and you hear this over there and that over here. You hear us do reggae and blues and jazz and funk and rap, and like you see that all of those things are having an influence because we bringing it out here like that.
That that's one of the biggest forms of flattery, man, you know, that they love somebody else's music that well, that they take it and they do an extension to it, you know.
And one day I picked up two albums, actually, two jazz albums, which I nicked from Sutton Library. they had a really good record department. I nicked an album by Herbie Hancock called Mr. Hands, and an excellent vocal album by Mark Murphy called Stolen Moments. And that was really, if you see it.
Well, to begin with, I would say that Bird had the biggest influence on me as far as jazz was concerned. He put, him and Dizzy put the B in the bop, the bottom on the top, so the sound going down, bop non-stop. So that was the first really musical reference point, you know, as far as being different is concerned. You know. But Max Roach personally taught me how to read contrast, getting an inside view of what was happening in the jazz world.
We're just examples of people that have grown up basically through clubs and through DJs playing jazz, whatever the meaning from anything from fusion right over to, you know, commercial jazz funk, playing those kind of records and just being turned onto those records, finding out more about the people who made them.
Jazz still goes over people's heads. That's what's good about the jazz dance scene. We package it in a way where I think everyone can understand it, or at least enjoy it, even if they don't understand it.
Jimmy McGriff, I play Hammond organ, and I try to play it anyway. Like I said, I just didn't figure it would work again like that. I'm overthinking, but I'm glad it did.
Stan Tracy can cook, man. I mean, Stan Tracy and Chubby Hayes, man. I'm sorry, he died. He shouldn't have.
When you come together, believe that what we can do together is more important than that. And go home and worship who you want to and sleep with who you want to and all that kind of shit. Like, don't bring that to the party.
Routine. Be a free spirit. So what if we dance to it? In its basic form, jazz is meant for dancing to, which is for the old crowd. They can't stand what we're doing, the way we're mucking around with the jazz. Perhaps it is bad in some ways. I think it's constructive. I hate that restaurant. Jazz restaurant atmosphere is disgusting. It's just an old cliche.
After a little while, we started seeing that certain musicians who'd been influenced by these clubs that were playing jazz were beginning to actually, you know, have their own bands, and they were beginning to sort of say something, you know, which wasn't being said anywhere else, and a whole new flavour was beginning to happen in the UK. So people like Snowboy, like James Taylor, like Galliano were beginning to kind of make music, which was definitely worth checking. At the time, a lot of the labels, the major labels, you know, wouldn't even sniff at it because jazz was a dirty word.
Master plan, peace and happiness in all the land. Oh! Hey now! Oh! Hey now! Be brave for the creator's master plan, peace and happiness in all the land. Hey! Reside in pale within the dark culture. I come with respect, not as a vulture. Being aware of another history. So I realize the race defining me. I believe in the spirit of man.
Woman.
Uses belief to help me.
Overstand.
Skin, race, culture, ideology, a difference in thought, but
small biology.
But when black is black and white is white, must resist the wrong
to expose the right.
So black, a culture unified and strong, revealing the truth through a history long. But then this culture come and talk to me. Learn me lessons and
dance.
Shares friendship, love and joke with me. Goes to school and clubs with me.
For I think Legends of History is a brilliant poem. I think for any white person who's involved in black music, I mean, basically, Rob wrote that poem for all of us, in a way, in that sense. I mean, I think that it's completely honest.
But I would never try to be black or claim understanding for which I
lack.
If you see the legacy of whiteness hanging from the bones,
bones, bones.
It's just that a body must give a spirit a home.
You'll see.
Let me see. We pray for the creator's master plan. Peace and happiness in all the land. Hey, hey! Oh!
Ow!
Hey! We pray for the creator's master plan, peace and happiness in all the land.
Ow!
Papa!
Ow!
Aha! We pray for the creator's master plan, peace and happiness in all the land.
Nobody move, nobody get hurt.
Hey!
Oh!
Say, we pray for the creator's master plan, peace and happiness in all the land.
Watch out!